अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? टुडे वी हैव टू डू एक्सरसाइज ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 13, द रॉक साइकिल, रॉक्स एंड वेदरिंग. क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस. फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट, विच ऑफ दीज इज द बेस्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ वेदरिंग? ऑप्शन ए, द ब्रेकिंग ऑफ रॉक्स ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस. ऑप्शन बी, द मूविंग ऑफ रॉक्स ऑन द अर्थ सर्फेस. ऑप्शन सी, the burying of rocks on the earth's surface. option d, the explosion of rocks on the earth's surface. correct option is a, the breaking of rocks on the earth's surface. statement number 2, which of these is not a form of weathering? option a, burrowing animals. b, global warming. c, heat from the sun. d, rainwater. The correct option is B, global warming. Statement number 3, rainwater is a weak form of which acid? Option A, acetic acid. B, carbonic acid. C, hydrochloric acid. D, sulfuric acid. Correct option is B, carbonic acid. Statement number 4, which of these statements about the transport of weathered material in rivers is correct? Option A, water only carries soluble particles. B, small particles travel further in a river than larger ones. Option C, large particles travel further in a river than small ones. Option D, the size of particles has no effect on the distance transported. Correct option is B, small particles travel further in a river than larger ones. Statement number 5, when a river slows down, option A, all particles are deposited at the same time. B, dissolved particles are deposited first. C, heavy particles are deposited first. D, light particles are deposited first. Correct option is C, heavy particles are deposited first. Question number 2, true or false? First statement, plant roots can cause rocks to shatter just like ice does. This is true statement. Statement number 2, stalactites are formed by water dripping onto them from the roof of a limestone cave. But this is false statement. Statement number 3, sediment is the name given to all material transported by a river. This is true statement. Statement number 4, sorting of material carried by a river happens when a river changes speed. This is true statement. Statement number 5, conglomerate is a sedimentary rock made from pebbles cemented together. This is also a true statement. Question number 3, pumice, granite and basalt are igneous rocks which comes from volcanoes. But this is pumice, this is basalt and granite. And we have to answer the questions. Question number 1, what pushes the molten rock to the surface of a volcano? Answer is, high pressure beneath the earth's crust pushes the molten rock to the surface of a volcano. Question number 3, part 2. Pumice is full of holes. Part A, how were these holes formed? Answer is, bubbles of gas released from molten lava make it frothy and sponge-like. Question number 3, part 2B, explain why pumice floats on water. Answer is, pumice floats on water because it has sponge-like holes in it, making it less dense than water. Part 3, how can you tell that granite and basalt are not pure substance? The answer is, they contain lots of different crystals. Question number 3, part 4, explain why the crystals in granite are larger than the crystals in basalt. The crystals of granite are larger than those of basalt because granite took longer to cool down. Question number 4. The diagram shows all the processes involved in the making of sedimentary rock. Whether this is 1, 2, 3, 4, there are 4 points and we have to describe what is happening at part 1. At the point 1, we can see that physical and chemical weathering of the igneous rock is taking place. And at point 2, particles of igneous rocks are transported by the rivers. And at point 3, the river slows down as it reaches the sea. Sand, gravel and pebbles settle as sediments on the seabed. And at point 4, layers of sediments build up over millions of years to form sedimentary rocks. Question number 5. The diagram shows an intrusion by hot molten rock. Question number part 1. What is an intrusion? Beta, an intrusion is very hot magma that is pushed into rock. Part 2. Where does the molten rock come from? Molten rock comes from the mantle of the earth. Question number 5, part 3. A. Name the metamorphic rock produced when limestone is heated. Beta, the metamorphic rock that is produced by limestone, it is marble. Part 3b. How does this rock differ from limestone? Limestone is a sedimentary rock. Marble is metamorphic rock. Part 3c. Give one use for this metamorphic rock. Answer is, it is used for making statues. Part 4. Metamorphic rocks contain crystals. Explain why there are more smaller crystals at X in the diagram than at Y. But we can see that in the diagram, this is point X. It is closer to the intrusions of magma. And point Y is away from the intrusion. The answer is, the area of contact between the limestone and magma is greater at X than at Y. Question number 6. Complete the table below by classifying each rock as either igneous, sedimentary or metamorphic. These are the rocks and we have to describe their types. Sandstone. Sandstone is a sedimentary rock. Granite is igneous rock. Marble is metamorphic rock. Limestone is sedimentary rock. Slate is metamorphic rock. Pumice is igneous rock. Question number 7. The diagram shows the rock cycle. This is diagram and it shows the rock cycle. There are different points A, B, C and D. And we have to answer the questions given below. Part 1 A. What type of rock would you find at A? This is the starting point A and we know that igneous rocks form the starting point of the rock cycle. So we will find igneous rocks at point A. Part 1B, name one example. The examples of igneous rocks are pumice, granite, basalt. Question number 7, part 2. What is happening at B? This is the point B. And we can see that molten lava is flowing down and solidifying at the point B. Question number 7, part 3A. What type of rock would you find at C? This is the point C and here we could find sedimentary rocks. Question number 7, part 3B. Name one example. There are many types of sedimentary rocks. Limestone, sandstone. They are different types. Question number 7, part 4A. What type of rock would you find at D? This is the point D and here we would find metamorphic rocks. And name one example, marble, quartzite, slate. They are different examples of metamorphic rock. Question number 7, part 5. How is sediment transported to the sea? sediments are transported to the sea by river. Question number 7, part 6. Where does the energy needed to drive the rock cycle come from? Answer is, the energy needed to drive the rock cycle comes from the very hot mantle. Thank you.